Till now we had completed the binary classification for email recognition. After constructing a future tree, the future tree is converted into decision tree. In the previous session we discussed the future tree is converted into decision tree based on majority class. After that, for the tree, I am calculating accuracy and true positive rate, false positive rate, true negative rate and false negative rate, some of the measurements. Now in this session we are discussing the performance measurements in graphical representation, that is visualizing the performance of the classification. These graphs are coverage plots, that is by using coverage plots we are visualizing the performance of the classifier. So to calculate accuracy we need a contingency table, or we need a confusion matrix. We already know how the confusion matrix. The confusion matrix contains 9 entries. Suppose predicted positive, predicted negative, actual positives, actual negative. For example, 30, 20, 10, 40, 50, 40, 60, 100. This is the confusion matrix or contingency table. From this table, we are calculating the accuracy. By observing this table, out of these 9 entries, if you know these 4 entries, it is easy to calculate the marginals. These are marginals. The marginals are dependent on this one. That is, if you know true positives, true negatives, false positives, false negatives, it is easy to calculate remaining 4 entries. These 4 entries are called degree of freedom, that is these 4 are selected freely without depend on anything. So this is called 4 degree of freedom. So not only these 4, so you are using the total number of positives, the total number of negatives. Suppose true positives, the total number of positives, that is this one, the total number of negatives and true positives and the size of the text, that is the total number of elements in the test set. That means if you know the total number of test sets and total of positive elements, total negative elements and total true positive, we automatically calculate true negative, false positive, false negative. Remaining all entries are easily calculated. But generally our interest is, so if you know any 4 degrees of freedom, we are calculating the remaining entries. Generally we are using the number of positives, the number of negatives, true positives and false positive. By using these 4 degrees of freedom, we are constructing a coverage plot. By using these 4 degrees of freedom, we are constructing, that is we are designing a coverage plot. The coverage plot is a rectangular coordinate system. The coverage plot is a rectangular coordinate system. Suppose this is the representation of the coverage plot. Rectangular coordinate system. The positives are placed on the height of the rectangle. The negatives are placed on the width of the rectangle. Suppose this is the rectangle. This is the coverage plot. For example, the values are 10, 20, 30, 40, 50. Assume 10, 20, 30, 40, 50. So the positives are placed on the height and negatives are placed on the width, and these are true positives and on the width we are placing false positive. That is on y-axis, this is y-axis. On y-axis we are writing the positives, on x-axis we are writing the negatives. So here we have to draw coverage plot. To draw the coverage plot, consider an example. In the previous session to calculate accuracy. To calculate accuracy, we are using a table. Suppose 30, 10. This 30 is a true positive, 10 is a false positive. This is one example. Suppose another example, 20 is a true positive, some 20 is the false positive. Suppose I am considering two examples. Suppose 30 true positives, 10 false positives in one case, 20 true positives, 20 false positives. This is another case. These two are two different examples. Now for these examples, I am drawing the coverage plot. On 10 false positives, we have 30 true positives. Suppose this is 10, this is 30. This is the plot. Assume this one as the class C1. Assume this is the class C1. This is some FP1. This is some TP1. This is FP1. This is some TP1. Similarly, identify this one. 22 positives and 20 false positives. This is 20 and this is 20. Assume this one as the C2. Assume this one as the C2. So for this I am predicted as a class C1. For this I am predicted as a class C2. This is the coverage plot. What we have observed from this coverage plot? Suppose if you know accuracy. Accuracy is some 0.9. Though it is a good accuracy. But based on this, how we are predicted it is a good classification. Observe this one. Among C1 and C2, among C1 and C2, obviously C1 is better than C2. C1 is better than C2. Why? The C1 has more true positives. The C1 has more true positives and fewer false positives. So C1 has true positives are more and false positives are less. That means it is a good prediction. Similarly, consider C2. C2 has, assume this is a TP2, this is FP2. Compared to C1, less true positives and more false positives. TP is less, FP is more. So obviously, the more true positives and less false positives, that means simply this is a wrong prediction. True means right prediction. So we have more right predictions and less false predictions for class C1. And class C2, we have less right correct predictions and more wrong predictions compared to C1. So obviously C1 is better than C2. That is, by using coverage plot, we are identifying this type of information. Assume, suppose we are considering one more graph. Sorry, we are considering one more. Suppose contains 20 TP. Contains, suppose, assume some more value, 40 TP and 20 false false. Where is the part? This one. Assume this class is C3. So a more complex example. Now I have three classes, C1, C2, C3. Which one is a better one? Which one is the better one? Observe the one. C1 and C3. Obviously C2 is not the better one. So C1 and C3. C1 has less true positives compared to C3. But C1 has C1 has less false positives compared to C3. Which one is better? Here we have a question. Depending on our requirement, suppose if true positives and false positives have equal importance, that means C1 and C3, any arbitrary choice is good. Because if you are considering true positives, suppose if your priority is only for true positives, only for true positive means the highest true positives is for C3. So your choice is C3. If your priority is on false positives, your choice is C1. You got the point? Here the point is very simple. based on either true positives or false positives, you have to predict the class. If your concentration is only on true positive, that is, the more true positives if you want to select. C3 has highest true positives compared to C1. So our choice is C3. That is, if the case is true positives, your choice is C3. If your prediction is based on false positives, which has false less value? C1 and C3, C1 has less value, that is C1 has value 10, C3 has value 20. So we are predicting C1. Suppose if both true positives and false positives has not at all important, so select any of these, either C1 or C3, both are good choices. This is the way we are visualizing the performance, of the classifier. So in this case, suppose draw a line between C1 and C3. Observe the slope of the line is 1. If you are drawing a line between two classes, line between two classifiers, if the slope of the line is 1, then the accuracy, of these two classifiers are same. If the slope of these two classifiers is 1, slope is equal to 1, then the coverage plot said that the accuracy of these classifiers is same. So by this drawing, we are visualizing the performance of the classifier. Thank you.